act to catch one.
You know, I'll tell you something. It's been a great day. You know, lots of fish in the park. You know, like a flying fish. You know how you catch a flying fish? What you do is you cast a reel and you hit it on the head and you catch it by the fly. I got one. Yeah, I got two, baby. No, I got three. You know, I have 9 lovers. My uncle, my dad, my brother, my sister, my mother, my father, and my stepdad. Yeah, I got a joke. What kind of actor is a real rock and roll star and looks like a fish? Mick Jagger. You know, I always wanted to know who invented the radio. Well, I was looking in my books, and when I turned the television on and I looked at the picture, you know what I seen? I seen men on horses, and they were going, radio, radio, radio! Yeah. One day, I was in the Hershey's kitchen, and the guy asked me if I had a calendar. I said, yes, I have a calendar. My calendar says 7 o'clock. What does yours say? No, I meant the strainer. Well, I said, the strainer? I go, that's a calendar too, but mine's more technical. Yeah. Well, did you know that if you cast your rod and you're going fishing, it's illegal to have a 3-hook? And I said, well, what about a 4-hook? And I thought I always good looked with a suit and a tie on my, and a fish tie on my suit. That's how you really rig them, you know?
Platoon. Each level in Platoon is different, so you'll have to master each one separately. You can't make it through this game without a map. Fast reflexes help too. They can't hit you when you switch rooms. Watch out for trip wires. Here are the explosives. Believe it or not, you can jump over bullets. Get this box, and you'll get an extra life. Leave explosives on the bridge. Don't shoot the villagers. Go to the third hut for a map of the tunnel system. Watch out for booby traps. Get a torch from the fifth hut. You'll need it underground. Then use the trap door to go down in the fourth hut. Go as fast as possible and follow the on-screen map. Take everything here, the flares and the documents. Take the medical supplies, flares and weapons, then exit. Follow the map. Take the secret documents and the compass. Go to the end of the tunnel, take the ammo, then go up the ladder. In this level, shoot every shadow before it becomes a person. Shoot them before they shoot you. You're fighting shadows here. Here's the fourth level. Use your compass, and good luck.
Our next game is Demon Attack, the hottest game in a Magic's lineup of VCS cartridges. Demon Attack is reminiscent of Space Invaders in that the player uses a ground-based cannon to kill airborne invaders, but there is a lot more to this game. Several techniques rather than a single pattern must be learned. The first four waves consist of eight demons each, but only three can be on screen at a time, and only the lowest one can return your laser fire. The other two just try to stay out of your way and are harmless. The firing demon will try to force you to one side of the screen where it is very tough to escape him. Don't let this happen. Spend as much of your time near center screen as possible.
Okay, I'm back. Okay, I have to apologize. Because I originally planned to play something that was vaguely anime, but then I realized I was going to play something that wasn't anime at all. So, my bad. Sorry, Jessicore. Specifically, Jessicore. But what I was originally planning to play wasn't super anime, so maybe I can be a little forgiven in that regard. It was Final Fantasy IX, and I still intend to play that. But this game's really good. This game's really fucking good. And no one gave it the shake I think it deserved. So, it's not Metal Gear Solid. Though I like your bet. Metal Gear Solid's anime, man. Nah, this is some real shit. Real fucking shit. I'm going to turn the volume up a little bit on this, because I don't think I've loved a game as much as I loved Max Payne 3 for a while. Lagging Target, that was a long time ago. Hold on, let me bump the volume up a little bit, because this game deserves to be heard. Also, it's very cinematic, so I'm going to be pretty quiet during the cutscenes, because the writing is fucking phenomenal. Have you seen your... Oh, did you change it from Weeaboo Trash? I haven't seen your handle yet. Joey Jojo, I will play Final Fantasy IX. I love that game. But right now I'm feeling this a little bit more. Also, you know, Max Payne is the Mel Gibson. Yeah. It's the Mel Gibson movie. So it's weird. I want to play on hard, but you get way less bullet time, and that's kind of the whole point of playing. I played it on hard a little bit before, and... It's a different game on hard. It's tough, dude. Max Payne 3 on hard is legit, but... Man, Max Payne, I feel for you. Rockstar did so good with this game. And I feel like it didn't sell at all, so, you know.
I'm just gonna get settled in. Time to move on. Get on with my life. Yes, absolutely.
Amazing OST. Joseph, you're right. That's a bummer when playing a game on hard changes the texture of the game, but that's kind of the point, right? That means it's multiple games in the same thing, and if you don't want that, you can just not play on hard.
Now, like I said, it was a long time ago.
I love that shot. Ugh.
Let it go.
He looks...
Seriously.
How scary is this shit, man? He looks at the picture of his dead wife, just like stares at it for 20 minutes, goes out, buys liquor. He's like, okay, now I know what's going on. Now I know what the rest of my night will be.
Style in Panama, or Hoboken, I guess. No, if I'm honest, I just got kind of bored of boozing.
Max Payne makes you sick.
Once in a while, but not all the time.
Turn on subtitles, great idea. I will do that as soon as I get out of this cutscene.
You're right.
Fuck, sorry. Let me crank the volume a little bit so people can hear in the meantime.
It wasn't doing me any favors. Maybe I'd lost my self-respect, but it's back. I'm excited. Really. I really needed a new start. I think you're right. I think I am gonna like it here. It certainly ain't New Jersey. It's my new life, just like you said. Listen, if you think I can still do a job, what have I got to lose? Apart from the weight. Very funny. Ha ha. Yes, that is a fake laugh, you jerk.
Joseph, that's an interesting point. The idea about mechanics scaling on harder difficulties instead of becoming obsoleted by harder difficulties. So, not to belabor the point too much, but bullet time is still very instrumental and hard, but it's your last ditch. You trigger bullet time when you need to clear a room and there's no way you can do it otherwise. And in that way... Hold on, I gotta be quiet for a second.
So I guess I'd become what they wanted me to be. A killer. Some rent-a-clown with a gun who puts holes in other bad guys. Well, that's what they had paid for, so in the end, that's what they got. Say what you want about Americans, but we understand capitalism. You buy yourself a product and you get what you pay for. And these chumps had paid for some angry gringo without the sensibilities to know right from wrong. Here I was, about to execute this poor bastard like some dime store angel of death. And I realized they were correct. I wouldn't know right from wrong if one of them was helping the poor and the other was banging my sister. I'd arrived in Sao Paulo a few weeks before. I was working a protection detail for the kind of people who need protection in a town like this. And what kind of town was this? One where I didn't speak the language and they didn't water down their drinks. So for now, we seemed to get along just fine. Of course, that was about to change.
Hey, brother.
Hey.
How's the cocktail?
Scotch. I never mix my drinks.
Well, at least not on duty.
Something like that.
Man, that favela is big.
Yep. Nothing like the view of extreme poverty to make a penthouse cocktail party really swing.
I guess they call it trickle-down economics.
That's funny.
It's supposed to be a charity thing. Drink and give money. I don't know, something for the kids. Hey, listen, man. We better look lively. This place is a nightmare. They just got cowboys running security downstairs. Something rotten in the air.
That didn't mean much. There was always something rotten in the air. The family we were protecting were local celebrities, rich parasites with delusions of humanity. The kind of people who end up in glossy magazines or body bags, depending on how their luck runs.
So where are they all? I see Rodrigo over there talking to that guy.
Yeah, I don't know him. That guy next to him, he's some kind of cop. I'm not sure. Serious though, big end cop, anti-gang sort of thing. I can't remember his name.
So who's this guy?
That guy's a plastic surgeon or some kind of surgeon. Tummy tucks and cock implants. Ha! Look at Marcel. Still dances like a fool.
Guess that's what a European education and a coke habit will do for Ricky Martin look-alike.
That's very funny, Max. Oh, excuse me.
I was mostly working for Rodrigo Bronco, a local businessman. Built things, did some charity, had things named after him, won awards, owned things, people. One of the trophies he had won was his wife, Fabiana. She was hot and wanted to be dangerous. Some good genes trying to fight their way out of a cesspit. She'd married well and was now at leisure to regret her good fortune. They got along as well as any rich workaholic and his younger airhead wife tend to get along. They mostly ignored each other. She spent a lot of time with his cokehead younger brother, Marcello. He was a good time guy if your idea of a good time was an expensive suit, a bottle of champagne, and nothing between the ears. The middle brother, Victor, had just walked in. He was a local politician. Guy was smoother than an oil slick on an iceberg and about as toxic. The rest of the crowd, I didn't know, but I could imagine the types. People who know if they drink enough, they won't have to feel guilty about their good fortune. Suddenly, things turned real ugly. Felt like our hangovers arrived right on cue.
Pass off! That?
I don't know what the fuck that was. Let's go.
Things had gone from fine to fucked up in about a second, and now there were two idiots at the wheel.
Clear. Got this floor?
Sure.
All right, look after yourself, bro. Stay safe.
It wasn't my own safety I was concerned about, trophy wife or not. I'd said I would protect the girl.
All right, sorry about the silence. Let me turn on those subtitles so I can yell over them, presuming that they are in the game. There they are. Yeah, Rainy Beth, you're right, actually. It's the longest I've ever been quiet. I like this game. It's well written. I am quiet. I give the floor to things that I think are better than I am, which is a weird way to say that. And also probably insulting to anybody that have ever interrupted, but this game is so well written. Holy shit. There are so many good lines. Delusions of humanity? What a fucking amazing phrase. So, I don't know. The writers of this game are fucking on point. Somebody said it's like 2000s noir. I mean, you're not wrong. That's exactly what it is. Do we ever play L.A. Noir? Turbid, I have never played L.A. Noir, and I should. I own it on PC, and I should... Oh, man. I just realized it's playing like a Brazilian Max Payne version theme. Fuck, that's awesome. I gotta remind myself what shoot dodge is. Oh, elf or mouse for. Perfect. And then I'm pretty sure bullet time is space. There it is. Alright. Less so than Alan Wake. I don't know, Franken-gun. I think Alan Wake is... Well, so it's two different companies. So this is Rockstar, and Alan Wake was Remedy. That was whereas Max Payne 1 and 2...
Only this time she wasn't calling for more liquor in her cocktail.
...was Remedy as well. Yeah, I didn't want to interrupt the story, Natalie Storm. You're right about that. And I apologize to the person who called me out for ignoring them in chat. I wasn't ignoring you, I just didn't want to talk over what I considered to be far more...
...trashy magazines and pretty trashy
...interesting
people.
Banter
I just
than
hoped I could keep them out of the crime section.
...contribute. So, on that note, let me bump down the audio of the game a little bit. Get this a little more conversational. Play Binding of Isaac. Oh yeah, I played the shit out of that game. I got to where I like beat bomb a couple times. I didn't get super deep. I haven't played Rebirth much, and that's my bad. Rockstar is good at slow-mo. I mean, Remedy kind of pioneered it with Max Payne 1. They were the first ones to do bullet time well. Also, just... Man...
He was out on one of the balconies, and I hoped... Not about to be thrown off it.
I don't want to seem like I'm playing up a role here, but their depiction of a dude who drinks to dodge pain is spot on.
Sooner or later, I'd have to go out there and see what was happening.
It's that exact arc. Like, you drink, you feel great, and then it all crashes down on you, and you feel like a shithead.
It might have been stupidity or drunkenness.
And that's like,
both.
That's good writing. That's human writing.
Insane risks, trying to save fallen women.
I don't have the skills to get the hard kills. Didn't send him for functioning alcoholic feels. I don't feel like I'm in functioning alcoholic territory. And I know that I'm slurring at this point, but...
No, you? Where the hell's Rodrigo?
I don't know, man.
That's water, by the way.
Thanks.
Somebody's gotta go find him.
That's resub. Space Kidded, thank you for the 4 months. It's a shitload of money you should not have given to me. Odds are there was something much better you could have spent that money on.
I imagine the elevator doors opening to a firing squad of muzzles. As far as I could see it, the one thing my plan had going was that no one else would be stupid enough to pull this.
Soul Samurai, 9 beers in. God bless.
What have you done with him?
Side of this. I fucked that up. Two shots to the dome.
Dragging Bronco along would slow them down, but not much.
I didn't say you were. Oh, sorry, Brittany. Perhaps I was projecting. Yeah, Brittany, yeah. I don't know. Oh shit. For me, it's... For me, I appreciate good writing. I appreciate writing that, in a video game specifically, it is so bizarre and atypical to have writing that both comes from the perspective of and understands a perspective that is anything beyond 16 years old. Most games are power fantasies, which I'm not gonna slag them for that. You know, it's media, whatever sells. But Rockstar specifically makes games for adults, and I don't mean that they have cussing and violence.
Bronco's next charitable donation would be to the worms.
But like the arc of Michael in GTA 5, or the characterization of that character is so far beyond what a 14-year-old could comprehend, because it's not for 14-year-olds.
Rodrigo was too rich.
Rockstar is the HBO of video game production. Sure, there's not really another company that's doing that. Spec Ops: The Line got almost as was basically as it, did. And that's it.
Once I opened the door, I'd actually have
yeah, dot reticles? I mean, I love dot reticles myself, so I'm alright with it. And you can turn them off, which is even better. Or at least, you could in other Max Paynes. Yeah, it's a very Rian Johnson thing. Yeah, you're right, it's grim. And the animations and stuff it's so on point. Max Payne is just great. Underrepresented an unglorified minority, the games aren't afraid to represent the dirty underbelly. Yeah, Ernie Beth, you're absolutely right.
Too late.
I like games that... I like games that have a human element and come... like, I want to feel like when I play a game that I understand more about the people who made it. And when I play a Rockstar game, that's how I feel. You know? Didn't Spec Ops have a lot of difficult choices to make? Not really choices, I feel like more they made you feel about the things you did automatically. So there are a lot of assumptions you make when you're playing a game, and you feel like you're the hero. Spec Ops kind of, really drove us home. Natalie Storm, I appreciate the offer, but no
thank
you.
Everything is okay.
Also, if perhaps this will help dispel the fantasy. I don't own a car, so I would have to bike to. Oh shit! I'm not paying attention. I was reaching for my drink already. No wonder Max Payne identifies with me.
You're okay.
Soul Samurai, what inspired me to play this?
Come on, get up.
Nothing really. I just really like Max Payne.
Come with me.
Max Payne 3 specifically. Although I like Max Payne 1 and 2 for different reasons. It's weird. Max Payne 1 and 2 were kind of tongue-in-cheek and kind of cutesy. Max Payne 3 played it super real, and I love that. Brittany Beth, do you have any bike? I thought it got stolen. It did get stolen. About another one. Calfu. Or, sorry. Calfu? I hope I'm saying it right. Max Payne 3 is fucking legit. Who wears a soccer jersey to a heist? Fuck. Brazilians. Brathilians.
Say so.
I played Max Payne when I was 6 and it turned out just fine. The good guys are reunited. Turbid, I'm curious. You should go back and play it again. Curious what you would think of it.
So who's this guy?
I don't know. Some kind of cop. Different branch of the police. Not UFE, but normal cops. I don't know about this stuff, politics. Everywhere politics.
Everywhere politics.
Shit, Max, you look kind of beat up.
Yeah.
Let's get this lot home
it's
and then
he's
I'll
drunk.
Get you home too. Come on.
He's always fucking drunk. He's either drunk or hungover. A lot of people like to draw, or sorry, maybe not a lot, but a couple of people in chat were drawing comparisons between Michael and Max Payne. I don't know that they're the same person. Michael's a hothead. Max Payne is a psychopath. There's a difference.
Back home, it was time for some R&R. The only way I knew how.
The only way he knew how. Getting fucking drunk and taking pills. Yep. Also, they worked in the pill mechanic to his character. How perfect is that? God damn it. Rockstar has some smart motherfuckers. I know I never will, but one of my life's ambitions is to just talk to Dan Houser and say, you are a smart motherfucker. God bless what you've done for games.
And with that, I guess I was ready for bed.
And please keep doing it, no matter what, please. I mean, surely the monetary reward has been appropriate because your game sell like bonkers because you understand how to appeal high and low? Damn. Joseph, yeah, similar white dudes in suits. They both drink. So maybe that's the like they both have like
A couple of days later,
complexes with women?
Work, ferrying the boss's broad and his dipshit of a brother out for the night so they could recover from their brush with mortality.
There are...
Then again, what did I expect?
Their brush with mortality.
These were the kind of people who went to nightclubs in helicopters. Fabiana had brought her sister along.
There's so many dynamite lines in this game. I think in, what is it, 3 or 4? Max Payne talks about how he got a hole in his second favorite drinking arm. That's the best line I've ever heard in a game, ever.
Sorry, what was that?
Oh, I was saying we get into a lot of scrapes, man.
Well, we're still here.
Hey.
Thanks to you, Max. I owe you my life.
Boom. It wasn't just him, huh, baby?
Oh, yes, Marcel. I'm sure you did a lot to save everyone.
So you remind you of your love for alcohol. No.
Very funny.
Thank you, Max. I don't know what I would do without my sister.
I love Max Payne 3.
More time doing something useful.
Because it does not make the image of a drunk, murderous psychopath appealing.
Did you hear, Faba? More bodies.
And it makes you play that character. It makes you see him in his degenerative spiral.
I'm just kidding. It is a cold town, man.
It's kind of like the modern Bonds. There's always been a kind of undercurrent depicting Bond as being an alcoholic, womanizing asshole. The new Bonds really hammered it home. And I like Max Payne 3 because it shows that an action hero is... It kind of deconstructs the myth, and I like that about it. And at least from your own following. Well, God bless, and see you around.
I love this place.
Have a good night.
I love it.
Yeah, the guy in the 50 cal. Airborne Navy, you're absolutely right. That's exactly the scene I'm talking about. Max Payne is the perfect anti-hero. He tries the best he can. You know, Turbo, that's interesting. I wouldn't even classify him as an anti-hero. I would say he's just absolutely morally devoid. And he says that literally in the opening. It's like,
that's pretty funny.
I've lost the ability to tell what's right and wrong.
Sorry.
I'm glad you are still with us. Come, I heard what happened. I've missed you. I would have called,
okay.
But you know how it is. Didn't want it to bother you. Okay. Hey, Marcel.
I think he just kind of...
You might have an interesting investment for your brother.
Alcohol abuse, some taste in non-glorifying, but also real enough that you can appreciate it. Brittany, that's exactly it. Yeah. Really sick depiction of alcohol abuse, simultaneously non-glorifying, but also real enough that I can appreciate it. That's exactly what it is. When you decide to abuse, and it really comes down to self-abuse, and sorry for getting kind of real in this way, but you reach this point where you feel so shitty you don't care what you do to your own body, you just want escape. So when you decide to abuse alcohol in the way that Max Payne does in this game, it's that arc. You drink, you have a high, basically, where the hangover hasn't hit and all the toxins you're imbibing hasn't really crashed down on you. Oh shit, Alpha Duck Squad is just subscribed. And you feel king of the world. So when he's on his balcony saying, yeah, I'm gonna fucking kill it in this town, he's forgotten all of his pain and he's feeling great. And then very shortly thereafter, he's been drinking poison all night that rams home. He barfs in the sink and passes out on the ground. It's, it's gross. It's somebody who's in a... Yeah, you're describing addiction. Halakalypse, you're absolutely right. You basically are using that as a means to punish yourself, but also as a means of escape. It's a bad cycle to get into. It's a terribly bad cycle to get into. And, God, how many games remotely accurately depict addiction in any sense? You can get addicted to shit in Fallout, but it's a status effect, and you dismiss it as easily as it comes.
I needed a real drink to deal with the electronic music and the robotic people.
Escape. Right? Minor inconvenience, Max Payne immediately has to drink a liquor. Not even just like a beer, liquor. It's gritty and it's unattractive and it's real and it's such a rare thing that I'm always drawn to it when it's done well. So it's weird, like, it's done well, but it's also combined with this action hero shit where he can slow down time and pop guys in the face. So, you know, it's pretty cool. So we got a sub-hype. I'm gonna wait for this cinematic to end, because I love this shit.
Oh, Max, I love you, man. You're fucking real, you know?
Undead Moosh, what's up?
Fuck them, people get me wrong.
Divine Singularity. A psychopathic Holden Caulfield. If by that you mean it, like an utter nihilist, maybe. It's Grim says, Rockstar has this ability to perfectly nail the blending of culture and humanity, GTA especially, if you look past the facade of
Thank
humor,
God he had left.
Everything you
more
see,
of his drivel and I would have to put a bullet into myself.
Just realness of humans they construct, it's actually captivating. I agree. I think GTA is underappreciated as a masterful satire of American culture. More than any movie, TV show, maybe South Park is an appropriate analog. Just due to the volume and timeliness of its satire, but I like how this shit goes down and he's gotta be like, he's on the clock and he's drinking. Oh, Max Payne, hold on, I gotta kill some other fuckers real quick. And then we gotta play a sub-hype. I only got five. Alright. One sec. No one really pays attention to the satire because the gameplay is so amazing. Ethan, you are describing the brilliance of GTA. The best media in the world appeals to everyone for different reasons. Or rather, there are layers. So, if you want to just come at a movie or a music or a game, just say, I like the shooting. I like the beat. I like how attractive the main actor is. Great. The best, the pinnacle of media will have something for everyone at every layer. So somebody who wants to really think about and chew in and analyze a work of art in its context and time and all this shit, an amazing work of art can do that. So to me, that's what GTA is. Rock and all of Rockstar's games in that regard, they're really amazing. And I would feel more sad for Rockstar as a developer if their games didn't sell bonkers every time they put one out. And I think that's also a testament to the fact that they're amazing developers. Their games sell fucking well because they know how to speak to the human experience on a base level and also a hyper intellectual level. Fuck, man, they made an open world Western game sell well. No one would have thought that would happen. But Red Dead Redemption came out and blew everyone away. So it's so fucking great. So fucking great. All right. Pixar. Six Dash brought that up. Six Star does a great job of that with their movies. Absolutely. They can take a high intellectual concept and make it approachable for anyone in the world. Like Inside Out or Big Hero 6 or anything. And that's the sign of a brilliant artist. That's something that anybody who works in a creative or fuck it, even a technical field can only aspire to. All right, we got a subhype to do. So I've picked something that is thematically appropriate. And as usual, I have to find a good jump in spot. So let me scrub it a little bit here. I think this is good. All right, let me scroll up here. They always know how to make a broken hero that everyone can relate to. Jojo, I don't think you're wrong about that. I don't think you're wrong about that. I think that in GTA 5, Michael and Franklin are kind of the two Alpha Duck Squad subbed. Thank you, Alpha Duck Squad. I apologize that it's taking so long to get to your sub hype. Let's do that right now. So thank you for subbing. Thank you for your 250. Please appreciate your boozy related sub hype. So, correct me if I'm mishearing that lyric, but it is, I'll be your best friend. I'll be submissive until the end of time? Oh, shit, I didn't listen to Tribe Called Red. I'm so sorry, Brittany. Yeah, thank you for reminding me. Here, let me punch that in right now. I'll queue up one of their albums right after the stream because you sold it to me. I meant to listen to it. I didn't, so You could get Twitch alerts so SubHub is easier, although I'm guessing you personalize the SubHub. Undead Mesh, I don't want subs to blare up on the stream. I don't want it to be automated. I want it to be personal. So, also, I like, you know, I like interacting personally. I like the personal touch. I like playing music. I love music. So, this is the way I incorporate it. On that note, you know, I got some ideas. I got some ideas percolating on how to make subhypes a little more festive. You know, shower thoughts, but I'll work them in. I'll work them in when I can. Let's see here. Yeah, QA, glass of scotch. That's how you do it. That's how you do it. Oh, somebody heading out? Oh, good night, Salty Vigilante. Thank you for watching. Well, you ever played The Godfather? I've heard that's great. I've heard that's a great game, and I haven't played it, and that's my bet. Same with L.A. Noire, by the way, Kieri Sleche? I hope I got that right. I could attempt an accent. Kieri Sleche? I hope I can approach it. Yeah, I touch viewers with my Alex Wiggle hands. Electric Pow Pow, or Electric Pow Wow Drum. Is that the track off of an album I should listen to? All right. I will listen to that. Now I gotta get back to shooting Brazilians. What you gonna do?
I hadn't seen it coming.
There's actually an achievement for nailing all those dudes.
It's hard to keep your eye on the ball through the bottom of a glass. I just hoped I could get to Fabiana and Giovanna in time.
There's so many fucking good one-liners. It's hard to keep your eye on the ball through the bottom of a glass.
I knew if I didn't get to the girls soon, they'd be leaving this place.
And then there's those visual call-outs that keep you running forward. I don't know how to feel about that stuff. I would like so.
The doors had been chained shut. I didn't need my.
I like that if you investigate the areas, you can find clues.
The guy making the noise was the boss.
I kind of wish that they didn't
around to cut me off from the other side.
Constantly prompt you to run forward.
And sure
but
enough,
I understand the.
A few seconds later, I had some company on the dance floor.
Also. This game is so fucking smart. Max Payne as a character was like, they barred the doors, they must be circling around me, and he was already moving. Also in that opening scene when he drops his gun when he's held up, and then picks it back up. That's a little shit, man. The little shit that's so good. Alright, we're going double ooze. What is it? Double micro M99. 9mm. I don't even know what I'm doing right now.
Time was a luxury I couldn't afford.
Is that bulletproof glass? It is. Shudder. Everyone needs to play this game through again. I wish that somehow I could convince more people to buy this game and play it because it's the game that a lot of people lament doesn't exist anymore, you know? Quantum Break is kind of that too, like single player focused, story focused, cinematic experience, gameplay tight.
Son of a bitch.
That was a bad guy, wasn't it? I love how if he shoot dodges into a wall, he like hits it. Holy shit, you can take so much damage on normal. I'm used to playing this game on hard.
All this unfinished business, and all I could think about was my unfinished scotch.
Got the special edition with the statue and everything? Yeah, Shatter. I don't know. I don't know that there's so yeah. Kiss girls. did the Die Hard thing.
Whatever the hell they were arguing about, it was time for me to add my two cents.
Cut a silhouette of that guy's head into the wall. I'm starting to wonder I should have played this on hard. The game you're describing, Sleeping Dogs? I don't know, Sleeping Dogs was open world action. It had the Ubisoft thing of like friends of the gate, here's a million things for you to do.
These guys had some real issues with the Broncos.
Also, I don't know, I tried to get in Sleeping Dogs, I just couldn't. The PC port wasn't hot. God, that was a really douchey thing to say. Time to pick up a different gun. Thought this was on hard. Nope, this is on normal. I picked normal because it makes it like you get more bullet time on normal, so I can do more shoot dodges and stuff like that.
I had to hurry.
It's more cinematic. Playing on hard is different.
Headed for the helicopter pad. I had to get to the roof before Giovanna and Fabiana.
When you're playing on hard, essentially bullet time and shoot dodge is your last resort.
I knew this was gonna be a bad idea.
You clear a room and accumulate the meter, and you burn it in a bad situation when you have to kill like three or four guys at a shot. And if you miss, you are dead. I like that. I actually like how the game scales in that regard. It makes you reevaluate how you use the resources available to you.
I was getting shot at by a bit of class of psychopath.
I didn't see you for sure, never played on PC, but the potential of something I liked. I thought the story characters were very good. Okay. Oh, Blue Choo Choo, I intend to give it another shot at some point. I haven't yet. It's a factor of time. I recognize the value of Sleeping Dogs, especially since I fucking love John Woo movies, you know? Usually never got special editions, Shuttered. Max Payne series is one of my first games that I really loved. Me too. Max Payne was one of the games I played. I have some weird memories of Max Payne. I remember, so at the time, and this is one of those lost memories. At the time, I inherited, I like that, where you drink him. Yeah, it's part of his character. I was driving a 1979 Type 2 Transporter, Volkswagen Type 2 Transporter. It's the quintessential hippie bus. Inherited it from my dad. He bought it when he was younger. I don't remember exactly when. But, when I was a teenager, he kind of recognized that I had an interest in it. He basically made it my charge. I fixed it up, got it. It was already in decent running condition, but I got it in actual running condition. Learned a lot about car maintenance because of that car. So, the nearest place to buy video games where I grew up was a Best Buy that was an hour away. So I remember getting into that car with my high school buddy, whose name was Rush, no joke. Who apparently was named, he took the last name, I remember this. He was named after the last name of the doctor that delivered him. So the doctor's last name was Rush, and that became his first name. He was a cool dude. So we were both sitting in the front seat of a 1979 Volkswagen Transporter, which I believe has 35 horsepower, and we were driving down Texas highways that were deserted because we lived in the fucking boondocks. Driving an hour to get to a Best Buy. We must have stopped at some restaurant along the way. Because I remember on the way back. Fucking botching my shots. So, hold on, I gotta pause to get specific here. We went to Best Buy, I bought Max Payne because I had a subscription to PC Gamer at the time. And I was like, this is the realness, we have to go get Max Payne! So we drove to Best Buy, we got Max Payne, or rather I bought Max Payne, and on the way back, I remember he had like a styrofoam soda cup, and while we were driving down the highway, he flipped it upside down, rolled down the window, and punctured it over the radio antenna, which was on the passenger side and just stuck up from the front of the car. So we shoved it down on the antenna and rolled the window back up. So we were just driving down the highway and there's this cup just kind of flapping on the antenna on the right side of the car. And then I remember we got back to my house and it was a cool experience, man. This is something that doesn't happen anymore. Like, I put the CD in, we installed it, and we just kind of played through the first couple of levels together. Kind of looking at the bullet time shit and we're like, oh, this is so cool. I kind of miss that stuff. The anticipation, the shared experience. Plus One commented, his life is like an introspective indie movie, I swear to God. And she's not wrong. Well, I mean, isn't everyone's life like an introspective indie movie? And I'm not saying that to be even more indie movie. I'm just saying every human being has their own experiences, and if you delve deep enough into them, you find a pretty amazing story. Hashtag deep. Yeah, you got it.
How is this getting around it? I am ill, deep.
How do you feel about Manhunt? I actually never played Manhunt.
Look, there she is there.
That was pretty indie. What are you talking about? That I had a car and somebody put a cup on my antenna? That's pretty... But for the fact that this was the car in Little Miss Sunshine, that's pretty... I mean, surely every 22-year-old has some story about their teenage friends. You heading out, Discord? Alright, well, thank you for watching. Sorry I couldn't give you more anime. What are you gonna watch? If this gets to you before you close the stream, I'd like to know what you're gonna watch. Oh, okay. I got you, Brandy Beth. I hear you. No, I did. No, I tried, but I failed. Dead. You dead. You so dead. All these Rockstar titles you never played. Well, I mean, just the one, L.A. Noir. I think that's the only Rockstar game I've never played. And that's on me. I should play that. What's up, Check Badger? There we go. Man, on normal you can just one-shot dudes anywhere. It's pretty weird. You can shoot them in the thigh and they go down. Who the fuck can shoot a rocket out of the air? A drunk asshole hanging off a helicopter, that's who! River Salmon, you're not a fan of L.A. Noir, it looks like.
There was a goddamn army of these goons.
Subate F. Ninaya?
Or maybe they just assumed the Bronco security team consisted of more than a drunk
I never played Scarface either, that's my bad.
Brazilian never was, who should have paid more attention.
American has been, and a Brazilian never was.
Either way, I needed to find Giovanna before they.
Did Max Payne 2 have him with a dog? Oh, you're thinking of Dead to Rights. That was not Max Payne 2, Shutter. But. You are forgiven for mistaking the two. Dead to Rights was essentially a Max Payne knockoff. Just those two? We're good? Alright. No, we're not good. Oh, shit. Well, you're not dead, are you? Ugh. For that reasoning, all I need is a helicopter. Well, get me a helicopter, Ethan, and we'll put this fucking theory to the test. I'll shoot a rocket out of the air. Ethan, you get me a bottle of scotch and a helicopter, and I'll do whatever the fuck you want. Max Payne 2 is when you can play as Mona. That is correct. The Fall of Max Payne. I wrote a review for Max Payne 2 for my college newspaper. Games journalism. How does that factor into the indie movie? Dead to Rights being fun. It was okay. I mean, it was a fun game. According to Steam reviews, I should hate this game because it had a pop-up about some shit. I really shouldn't have phrased it like that. Phrasing! I'll phrase shit however I want. Man, Max Payne... I loved Max Payne 2. Bizarrely, my... That was weird. Bizarrely, my greatest association with Max Payne 2 was the... the coining of the phrase asshole physics, which I think came from something awful. Essentially, they said, like, when these physics are in a game, you become an asshole. Oh yeah, this part. They trick you because it seems like you should use the shotgun, but you shouldn't. Oh shit. Oh, reload, Max Payne. We got gangsters to shoot. Whatever these guys are. Turn that dude's head into meatloaf. Siphon Filter 1 and 2. I never played the Siphon Filters. Got him. Ethan, you can't get in that vape life. I'm sorry, dog. The rest of us are having a great time. Vaping like mad dogs. River Salmon? Man. Giovanna still you didn't like Max Payne 3 as much as 1 and 2? Second.
And if Fabiana wasn't dead already, I was guessing pretty soon she'd start wishing she was.
I don't know.
I was up for one god.
I think Max Payne 1 is probably my favorite, just because of the context in which it came out, this was the bullet time mechanic.
Where the hell was
but 3
Passos?
Is
we
so
were
good.
Failed cops failing miserably at being bodyguards. He approached
I think objectively, in terms of writing and production, Max Payne 3 is probably the best of all of them. But if you factor in context, Max Payne 1 is so fucking good.
Giovanna! Max! Over here!
Like, if you played all of them back-to-back, I feel like the difference in quality would be very apparent.
We're gonna get you out of here.
Assholes. Where is he?
The visual transformation of Max in this game is top-notch. It's grim. You're dead on.
Right there.
I feel like they do the perfect thing. They show you modern Max. They even flash back to, like, old Max Payne, when he has his leather jacket and his weird, like, kind of cheetah print vest and all that shit.
Seems
and then
like
they show you
the
new psychopathic Max with no hair and just murders
my
everybody.
This was the drink.
It's all about
was the sister.
It's all about fucking
things were turning pretty ugly in this town.
The slide
the
into
girl was gone and part of me wished I was too.
The slide into total schizophrenia. What am I thinking of? Sociopathy. Is that how you say that? Sociopathy? I don't know. 4 a.m. on the East Coast. Sleep. Please sleep. Joe Epsicata. I don't know if that's how you say that, bud. Thank you for watching, man. If you gotta sleep, please sleep. I am essentially Max Payne at this point, except I hope I never get that sad. Like, just fucking crushing a glass while I'm drunk and bleeding and whatever. I've had a couple drinks, I'm playing a shooty game.
Well,
I'm just riding it out.
What choice do we have?
It's my last drink for the night.
Nonsense before.
When this is done, the stream's done.
I don't like the feeling of this. What about you, Max?
I don't know. I'm no expert on hostage negotiations. I know
chat link
are,
free. Check Badger, it is. But
time for America. I know
please make your links context appropriate, and if they are not work safe,
money,
tag
man.
Them as such. So, nudity, sex,
we
all that kind of
always
stuff.
Been targets.
Siphon Filter 1 is just as good as Metal Gear Solid.
As it pains me, I don't see we have a
disassociation. That's a certain way of saying it. Yeah. Yeah, 6- got it. There you go.
We all know what I'm saying.
Who do you think is targeting your family?
Haters.
Who can say?
Haters.
Life in this country is not easy, you can see that.
Drink slowly.
I've tried to do business the right way, but that's not
I am in the nursing period of the evening, so divine singularity, I am drinking slowly.
Of course
slowly.
I made enemies, but I've also paid a lot of bribes. I have no idea.
It's probably that street gang trying to get on me.
I don't know.
Isn't the shift into the anti-hero archetype everyone's favorite storyline?
Commando Sombra.
Persuasive Turnip.
They're not from any of the favelas around here.
So somebody classified Max Payne as an anti-hero previously. He's not an anti-hero. He's a psychopath. There's this push to classify the player character as a hero. Or at the worst, an anti-hero. He's neither. He's a bad guy. He murders people. He doesn't care. And this is kind of the idea that they set up in the prologue, and they try to prime you as like, you're not playing a hero. You're playing a mercenary. He has no moral boundary at all. Yeah, and Turbid's dead on. Trevor is a psychopath. He's not an anti-hero by any stretch. I feel like Rockstar has tried to push this, is that just because you're playing somebody doesn't mean they're right. And that's something that I feel like games have kind of gotten better at in a weird way, but people still haven't grasped onto. Oh yeah, his second favorite drinking arm.
Easy, pal, easy.
Thoughts on the Doom beta? I love it. Amy P21, I'm also... Alright, Brittany. I will listen to Tribe Called Red.
Apparently someone up in the nosebleeds didn't like the game we were playing. The money was gone, and I was next if I didn't get off that field. The bullets came from long range. They were well-armed professionals, and I was starting to feel decidedly amateur.
Shutter, I don't think they had the like drug sequences that they did in 1 and 2 and 3. And I'm fine with that.
There's gonna be a first kid around here somewhere.
I don't know. I liked them, but I wasn't attached to them.
I've been shot more times than I could remember. But this felt different. Maybe fate was sending me a message, trying to tell me my luck was finally about to run out. Or maybe I just severed an artery and was bleeding out like any number of fools who got shot playing with guns. Either way, I was failing fast.
I love if you hold forward, it still pushes you towards the wall. So smart. So somebody mentioned you can be both the protagonist and the villain. Yes, if you're talking in pure mechanics, the protagonist is the character who advances the story.
At least one of us had a gun.
Rather,
that raised our chances of survival all the way from nil to slim.
They have the agency in a story. So,
on, Max, let's go.
For example, in The Dark Knight, the Joker is the protagonist because he's the only character who actually advances the story. He's not the good guy, but he is the protagonist. It's kind of weird. Yeah, it is some Sin City-esque dialogue. The 1 and 2 is so freaky.
Because
you're in the house with the wife and the kid and the wife died? Isn't it the same thing in Max Payne 1?
While chaperoning socialites around town and making sure the poor people didn't
get too close. How many days out of the week? How many days do you drink out of the week? I've been recently drinking 4 times a week and I put on hella weight. Delta X Red, I keep it to 1 day a week. If that. There are weeks I go by not drinking at all. It's weird. I have the persona of being the drunk, and that's fine. The Rat Pack had their drunk as well. People just kind of want those archetypes in a collection of personalities. And I like drinking, so whatever, man. If that's the role that I'm into, I can play that role. And I do. Certainly the narrative of my life is driven towards that, so... That's
like
fine.
All the fun.
But, I do not drink 4 times a week. Do you like honey whiskey? No, it's far too sweet. See Casey.
I'm getting flashbacks to that wedding we worked in Aruba.
Sammy Davis Jr. confirmed. Delta? You understood the reference then. There you go. What's weird is, if you look at the Rat Pack and pre-Rat Pack, the persona of the drunk actually shifted people. Dean Martin, see? You got it. It's different people. It's all theater, man. So, whatever.
You okay, bro?
It rounds out the group. It provides a sounding board.
Yeah,
you play into it. That's show business.
Is it bad?
Blue Moon. You mean the beer, Turbin? It's okay.
Thank you.
Divine Singularity, you like the kind of heavy drinking philosophical archetype. Something about it that amuses me, and my persona seems to fit it. I mean, it absolutely does. Moreover, I mean, I typically am a philosophical type in general, except I have the good sense to keep my mouth shut most of the time. When I'm drunk, I don't give a shit, so I just say whatever comes to my mind.
Cheese party.
I have no idea.
So,
brother could be anyone.
I actually am that archetype.
Access to high-powered sniper rifles. Trained killers.
Yeah, this is a pretty good beer. Low calorie.
Great.
First beer you had since you turned 21. Had 4 the other day. Well, Kirpin, I'm glad you liked it.
Well, I guess we get these Commando Sombra their money.
But there was a wild, vast world of beer out there.
She won't come back in such good shape.
So, do experiment. You'll find things you don't like, you'll find things you do. But Lumen's alright, it's pretty solid.
Come on, come on.
Alright, I gotta shoot some motherfuckers. How many? Are we from the lineup? And let's go. Alright, I fucked that up real hard. I didn't get any of them. Whoa! I mean, persuasive turnip. Teenagers in America like to lament the difference in drinking age between Europe and America. I would say the difference is in America, and this is something that's maybe not widely appreciated. America is much more car-driven, much more of a car culture. And booze and cars do not fucking mix by any stretch. So, in Europe, you can drink as long as you get on the bus to go home. Let's see here. You don't have to answer, just ignore soap, but I was wondering if you feel Funhouse has been more successful under Rischteeth, or at least feel the move is positive for the team brand. Are you asking in... Are you asking in comparison to Machinima? Because if that is what you were asking, I feel like I don't have to answer that.
Lived and died this game.
I feel like the objective evidence of the world answers that for me. And, you know. Oh, man, I fucking love the TVs in Mike's Payne. Lords and ladies.
Dissolve. Coloque dissolve na máquina de lavar e apague os pecados de ontem. Dissolve. Como se nunca tivesse acontecido.
This is INC. A star midfielder for one of Sao Paulo's most famous clubs, Galatians, was killed in a bloody shootout at a local nightclub. A witness who captured this video said there was a fight between gang members and private security forces. It is not yet known whether this was a targeted hit or if the football star was simply
in the
wrong place at the wrong time.
Let's see here. I'll be turning 21 next month. What would you recommend to drink? I just want to stay away from anything weak. XMM. Well, I would recommend taking it easy when you start. Because you have no basis of comparison for how it feels, so you don't know where your boundaries are. That's kind of like going into a gym and saying, I've never worked out before, but I want to lift heavy. The trainer's going to be like, why would you take that risk? You have time. Let's take it easy to start. Let's find your limits. It's only going to take a couple of days. Like, what's your rush? You have your entire life. So, let's be safe.
Hardly a textbook hostage exchange.
I would recommend to you,
skip that class.
Your first night, take it easy.
Okay, come on.
Have let's one go. Drink, maybe two. Learn how it feels. And then sober up, drink a lot of water, have a good sleep. Your second night, have three, maybe four. Learn how it feels. Drink a lot of water, go to sleep. And if you feel like pushing it to the wall, please do it after. You've had a couple of experiences with alcohol first. There's no reason to push it that hard the first time. Unless you... One water for every drink is a good rule. What do you have to prove, I think, is the important question to ask. Unless you have this idea in your head that, like, I'm a real tough guy or girl. I don't want to assume gender, but... can, like, hold liquor. Whatever. Who cares? You can get there. You have time. So... Yeah. Six Dash says, when I turned 21, I had way too much vodka and it was horrible. Also with it, Brittany says, also with any substances, if you're pushing limits, please do it with friends who are remaining sober and care enough about you to take care of you. All very good advice. So... My advice to you, heed the wisdom of your elders. There's no reason to go heavy right away. You can do that when you want, when you are familiar with your body and how your body reacts to what you're doing. But, you know, you have time. You have many years of drinking ahead of you. There's no reason to rush it. So, just take your steps up. Do it like anything else in your life. You know what? When you're learning to drive, you don't jump in a Ferrari. You jump in a shitty Ford Focus and you step your way up. Same with drinking. Have a couple of weak drinks. Have a couple of beers. Appreciate the effect. And then have a glass of liquor. Just one. Oh, I got dead. Let's see here. Shutter, maybe I didn't see your reply. I'm apologizing. Yeah, go ahead and repaste it. It's fine. So Joseph says, this perspective comes from Randy joined. Find us an introduction, but it seemed like a machine. You guys had to prove yourself and let's see here. Your value in keeping you on. Rooster Teeth has allowed you to experiment and find a larger audience. As evidenced by the huge success you guys have earned since joined Rooster Teeth. That's one way of looking at it. I'm not going to say that that's wrong. I don't want to get too in the weeds on that.
Where the hell's he going?
But let's see here. Shutter writes, more you mean for the quality of content and your happiness with the work that you've done compared to how you had to work for Machinima. I understand if you don't want to answer pertaining to liking one more than the other. Well, so I can answer that in a couple of ways. I don't want anything that I say to be taken out of context. So I'm going to be very diplomatic with what I say, and I hope you can appreciate that. So we wouldn't have made the switch if it wasn't in all of our interests. That's just human, like base human economics. And I guess to put it, like I'm putting this all in logical terms as somebody from the outside. So I'm not really giving you guys any new information. I'm just giving you different ways to appreciate what you already know. So let me put it that way. If we didn't appreciate being at Rooster Teeth, we probably would find another company to work for. Because we did that once, why wouldn't we do it again, right? So, as evidenced by the fact that we are still at Rooster Teeth, and are growing? So in that respect, maybe there are some things that you guys don't know, but there are things behind the scenes where shit's moving. And it's moving in some pretty exciting ways. So personally, and I can only speak from my personal perspective, I'm pretty happy at Rooster Teeth. They've been great partners. They have been very enabling and welcoming on a number of professional and creative levels, so it's been a great experience. It's something that I'm very thankful for. Let's see here. Thank you. Haven't been at any social gathering, so wasn't sure, but now we're very much appreciated. Okay. Most I've ever drunk was a tiny cup of sangria, and it made me feel a little warm in a good way. I don't like alcohol, it tastes bad to me, and I don't mind being affected, but when I turn 21, I'm going to have my mom drink sangria. Dimesh? That's not bad. That's a good place to start. The warmth and relaxed kind of thing is one of the surface level effects of alcohol. It's a depressant. It makes you relaxed, it makes you unwind, and on a... So there's the relaxation, but on a physical level, it makes your muscles relax. That's just what it does. So, yeah. If you get far enough, it starts to fuck with your mind in some weird ways. And if you're curious about how your mind works, that's an area you can explore. But I'm not going to go too much further down that.
He says he doesn't know who the snipers are.
Yeah, Torbid, I'm glad we're doing heists again, too. I don't know why it took us so long. I love the heists, man. I have whipped cream vodka, pinnacle? Yeah. Whipped cream vodka plus Diet 7-Up, or it's 7-Up 10 when they had that line out. That was the creamsicle, man. That was a good drink. How much longer will you be streaming? Well,
let's get out of here.
Let's see, we got...
Here comes friends.
Ah, shit. Fuck. Got a baseline drink left. He moved. Oh, I'm fucked. So, I said before, as soon as I finish my drink, that's it. If you're asking if you can go to sleep, you should go to sleep. I have maintained time and time again that this is not worth losing sleep over.
Son of a bitch.
Oh, man. Ugh.
About the same as before. Looking forward to getting
I haven't trained Battleborn, no, Detto. But so I've heard descriptions of the game mechanic. And on an intellectual level, it doesn't appeal to me, but I deserve it a shot because I like Gearbox, and they're very smart, and they make good games. They really do. So, based on that pedigree, I deserve, or rather, they deserve my time. So I need to play it. I do, but I don't know. They may be onto something. Yeah, Joseph, right? The detail where he's like carrying a big gun with the smaller gun. You don't get to carry, like, 18 guns. It's great. You're just some unhinged psychopath. Shredder writes, so I had the question on the line. Love your guys' content. I hope you guys have as much artistic freedom you guys deserve. Because your content is amazing, and I want to see you guys grow and create more amazingness. The Starburst Orange Creamsicle is amazing and menu. So... Oh, shit. It's fucked up. So...
Seem nice enough.
Creative freedom is not, ironically, is not the goal.
Were they cops?
Because I guess what could be argued, we're a creative collective, but we're also a business, so we could do whatever we wanted to. We could go into the office tomorrow and say fuck it and abandon our production slate. We could abandon Demodisc and Open House and Dude Soup. We could throw out every show we make that has an established viewership and just do whatever the fuck we want. Ultimately, that is creative freedom. But our revenues would also probably dive through the floor, so... Sure, we have creative freedom in the sense that we can do that, but that doesn't make it a good idea. Oh, his hat popped off. That's gross and awesome. Your bro gets drunk a lot and you have to drive him around. It's interesting to see how it affects people. I agree. It affects people in different ways, which is the crazy thing. It's kind of creepy to see the people who just get mad?
A little late to be giving him his last rites.
Or...
Look at this blackjack. This is high-end gear. These guys are serious.
Or sad. Yeah, I don't know. It's just kind of a... It's just kind of...
Christmas. Come on, let's keep moving.
We've still got a sniper on us.
It's kind of concerning when you peel off all the layers of a human being and they get abusive and like angry and want to fight. And it's just like, damn, dude.
I might have written a book on dumb ideas, but
you got some shit you got to deal with. Joseph writes, their hat thing. Only thing that's holding against Gearbox is their habit of taking up side projects, sandbagging them, and using that money from their own properties. Colonial Marines addicting them forever. May have problems when they got them, and they still paid to make them, and they still failed hard. I don't know about that. Were they commercial failures? Did I do the wrong thing? Should I not have moved up here? Can I go in that door? Hey, die for it! Yup! Yeah, there we go. Oh, maybe I shouldn't have done that.
Look out!
Fucking wasted bullet time. Wow. I mean, to a degree, that's it. Can't you celebrate? Can't I feel a certain amount of gratitude towards Gearbox for fucking getting Duke Nukem Forever out in the world. And it wasn't a good game, but it was a fun game. I had fun with it. I actually liked playing it. It felt like a Duke Nukem game for me. And I'm appreciative of that. I don't think that it was really a game that hit the standard of 2012 or whenever it actually came out, but it did feel like a 90s Duke Nukem game. And when you won a Duke Nukem game, would you prefer something that's polished, modern, and clean, or something that's gross, gritty, and weird? Fabiana, if the wrong people got paid. Yes. Take away from your content to flood Ferrucci stuff, even though I honestly enjoy when you guys collaborate. I hope the partnership doesn't take away from more granular branded content. Ah, Shutter. I understand what you mean. That's not a concern yet. Hopefully it never will be, but I see where you're coming from. I see where you're coming from. All I can say is it's not a concern yet. Oh, there's so many bullets flying. Let's see here, but really both companies made great stuff, and I feel like it was a good move on your part to go with them. I feel the same way. Personally speaking. Again, personally speaking, I wouldn't have done it if it wasn't what I wanted to do. Yeah. Mr. Teddy Bojangles, I'm glad you made it to the stream. I do have a bit of bad news for you. I'm probably not going to be up too much longer. It's pretty late in my local time.
The smell in this place reminded me of how long it had been since I'd had any food. A drinker eats when he's loaded. A real drunk eats when he's not.
Shit. That was a little close to home, Max Payne, because I haven't eaten in a long time. Hoey. To be thorough, I had lunch, and then I worked out, and then I had milk and protein powder. That was my dinner. Which I'm gonna guess was 300 calories?
It was time to introduce our sniping pal to something more intimate and short range.
But I do have a dinner prepared. Oh! Thoughts on Bro Team if you know him, especially his relationship with Machinima. I have no thoughts on that.
Alright, this one's yours.
I think, to be diplomatic, Machinima has had a series of series of managerial oversights, and I was the subject of that. I, as a contractor, went, I want to say, 2.5 months without being paid. And let me tell you, making rent when you have worked your ass off and continue to not be paid for work you've already done, especially when your contract says you should be paid in 45 days after sending an invoice, is frustrating. But I dealt with it diplomatically, which is to say I kept my mouth shut. So I don't know.
Shit, they got the guy with the bag.
Stay here. Cover me. I'll go after him.
Keep your headset on.
I think that there are times as a human being you get dealt a terrible shit hand by people. And the way you deal with that can kind of plot the path for how the rest of the next couple of years go. Steph, I have serious food. Don't worry. My serious food is ready to be eaten. I will eat it as soon as the stream is over. Which is to say, as soon as my... Hold on a minute. As soon as my donut cup is empty. Which... Oh, wait, wrong way. It's very soon. I'm at the dregs right now, so... One good swig and that'll be it. But, taking a lot of damage. The sequence is very cool. Also, this music is so fucking good. Reminds me, I have to find the soundtrack for this game. Streaming tomorrow? I don't know about that. I don't know about that. We'll see. There's a UFC event on. Matt and I are probably going to hang out and watch that. Yeah, Steph's about to do a run. God, nothing can slow that woman down. She is a constant lesson in what the human experience is capable of to me. while I sit here and play a video game. She is on, I want to say, 3 hours of sleep and about to run in a gross rundown 90s hotel room that she's been sending me pictures of. Yeah, Steph, I'll tell my aunt you said hi. I was thinking about going to round one as well. Sandra has a EMU's card for me. I'm going the wrong way. So I want to see what this glowing thing is. 3 hours sleep. Mother of God. The Wimble Pipes bike map. Yeah, I'll get there eventually, Turbot. Sorry, I saw your DMs. I just didn't reply to them. Today was really crazy. So Fridays are our crunch day every week. Essentially, we have our weekly production and we try to get it done. And over the course of the week, and this is kind of how it goes as a production company, we entertain and shift around our production load to accommodate all kinds of other realities like ad deals, guests, impromptu. Where the fuck am I supposed to go? This should not be a problem. Why am I getting fucked up right now? Right, oh, there we go. It's a door. Like no, dude, Turbo, it's okay. It's okay. Don't apologize about that. But so essentially, there's a number of things throughout the week that kind of delay our production. And that all comes to a head on Friday afternoon, when we have to get the weekend and basically Monday and Tuesday's videos edited, exported, loaded, scheduled, and ready to go up. So, you know, I stayed at work until 8 o'clock today. You can buy the CD from Rockstar directly digitally on iTunes. They have soundtracks up on SoundCloud. Alright, fuck yeah. I'll see if I can. I need to find a way to pay for it. Because it's so good. So, anyway, peek behind the curtain there, I guess. It's more complicated than just fucking around in video games all day. And you gotta put in some thankless time to make sure that the machine keeps turning. That's just the way it goes. Part of the job. Oh boy. Come on, Max Payne, reload. In terms of unforeseen circumstances in which videos need to be edited in a different order than originally planned. Oh, that happens all the time. So we have a production slate, and we basically fill in those gaps, and this is basically Bruce's job as a studio head, I guess is what you would call it. It's to look at the big picture and say, okay, we've got these days and these video spots that need to be filled, and to shift around editing responsibilities to make sure all those videos get done on time and are appropriate quality. So it's all about evaluating the... Oh shit, I got dead. It's all about understanding the speed, speed, skill, and resources you have available of all your editors, assigning projects to different editors to make sure that they get done on time. But yeah, there are a lot of times where a project has been cycled through multiple editors. Oh boy. Because one editor has been busy with something, and then that editor has to move on to do something else. Production life. Exactly, Ethan. Why was he holding his hand up? That was weird. Do you guys still have a GTA video to upload on Thursday? The 40-minute dinosaur one didn't go up yet. Why, you mean like this Thursday? This coming Thursday? No, that's not my job. Sharus could tell you. A There's a reason why you can't do drunk gameplays on Fridays, because that's also when you have to work the hardest. Ethan, you're dead on. Conversely, we like to do drunk gameplays on a Friday because it's, personally speaking, the day where, you know, we have the most padding, and also we can drink water and sleep in if we need to. So it's tough because, yes, you're absolutely right. It's the day we have to work the hardest. It's the day when all the work comes crashing down. Or rather, all the shuffling we've done. Like, we have no more space to shift things around. So that's when everything has to be done. Whether or not there are other realities to deal with. So, yeah, it's tough. Typically, when we know a drunk gameplay is coming up or a drunk session is coming up, we crunch to get everything done well ahead of time. So we can do a drunk gameplay on Friday and do it with the workload completely clear and just get blitzed and have a good time.
Maintenance elevator.
Is it a stressful job? Morphe D, absolutely. It's the most stressful job I've ever had. But there's bad stress and there's good stress. Bad stress is kind of being held accountable for problems you have no control over, being shit on for things you can't help. The good stress is what I consider to be video game stress, which is, here's a challenging objective, but you have all the tools to do it. Or you can learn through failure, which is kind of what I consider my job to be. So, in a weird way, my job has kind of become a video game? Or rather, it has provided to me the kind of enjoyment and satisfaction that I normally got from playing video games. It's the same kind of thing. You can visibly see your skills improve. Oh shit. What a great mechanic, by the way. The spiral down shot. So yeah, it's stressful and it's tough and challenging, but it's also very rewarding. And what time I've spent on this earth has made me appreciate that. So
okay,
much.
Shit.
Your GTA costume? Are you gonna dress up like your GTA character?
How's it looking, Max?
It's all clear up here.
Shutter, would you move to have your dream job or try to make the dream closer to home? I mean, I did move, so that's my answer. But, I think now and going forward, it's going to be easier to have your dream job move closer to home, so it's hard for me to give you an accurate answer. Or rather, to answer your question, I did and would.
Going back in, bro.
Oh, Vanquish's emergency slowdown? Yeah, it's very similar to that, Joseph. You're very right about that.
You're kidding me.
Also, Steph, you never finished this? I didn't either! I got to the like favela part of it.
Help me out here, Max. Shoot, Max, shoot!
I'm shooting. What the fuck? Oh, there's travel time for the bullets. River Salmon, I'm missing out. Yeah, no, you've been raving about the ending of this game for quite a bit, so. Remember this area? Yeah. I got further than this. The final act is fan-fucking-tastic. I'm excited to get there, and
I hear you.
I don't remember what recently reminded me of this. I think it was actually playing, I think it was playing Quantum Break. That reminded me, like, man, I never finished Max Payne 3. You know, it's the Rockstar kind of Remedy crossover there. So I wanted to go back and play it. Maybe finish it. Prismanasty, no, I have not played Battleborn. It's an open beta, right? I should try it. I should just download it and try it. There's no reason not to. What did I stop at? I remember like a, I remember a Skidoo chase.
Just stay calm.
Oh, you're fine.
Aren't you shooting anyone?
So just so you guys are aware, after this chapter's over, that's gonna be it. The stream's gonna be over. I also have to use the bathroom. Kind of bad, but I'm pretty sure this chapter's almost over. Open beta?
I can only shoot one at a time.
Open beta? Okay, I'll check it out. No reason not to. Gonna apply to you guys' internship in the fall. Alright. God bless, Turban. Have you ever personally experienced anyone that has burned out or been too stressed and busy that they're physically sick and can't continue working at that rate? Passive turnip.
Damn, bro. That wasn't fun.
Listen to me. You head for the chopper. We need to be ready to get the hell out of here. I guess I'll
I have seen people that have been worked too hard, and their work quality suffers because of it. So, a good boss will recognize this and give that person a break. Or shift things around. Steph, I feel like is a better metric on this. Or a better authority. Because she's worked in game development. And I have my element of stress. And I feel like I deal with a normal job's level of stress. Game developers are on some next level shit when it comes to stress and burning out. So I'm sure she could tell you a number of stories about how talent gets immolated. Alright guys. Fallen cup empty. Pretty sure that's the end of the chapter? Maybe not? I don't know though. If there's more shooting to be done, that might be it. Because boy, I have to use the bathroom. And that may as well be a convenient cutoff.
Place was like Fort Knox.
Hey, Passos.
Passos. So I happen to be on a games dev course at university.
Where are you?
I mean, that's okay, Passive. It's possible to not... It's possible to not be in a campfire and be a game developer.
Remind me again, who are these fine gentlemen?
Game developers have a union yet, or is it still the Wild West? I think it's Wild West to the extent that... And somebody kind of called out that I throw this around a lot. But it's free market. So, theoretically, if a game developer or game publisher had humane working conditions and no crunch and all this stuff, that game developers would flock to them, but...
Now we've lost the wife and $3 million. The boss will be giving us a raise at this rate.
Yeah, it's messed up, all right. Come on. We gotta get out of this place.
Smart how you handle deadlines.
Take care of that guy in the IT tower. I'll meet you at the chopper.
I'm gonna make a run for the light rig. I had a hole in my second favorite drinking arm, and the only way we were likely to get Fabiana back now was in installments. Whoever our uninvited guests were, I was about done playing soldiers.
Oof. Alright, guys. It was going to a head there, but I think that's it for tonight. It's getting late. I've got a full bladder. It's 2 a.m. I am gonna cut it off, so yeah. That line is so fucking good. Is Steph Revesen a game developer? Yes. Yes, she is, so you should listen to her. Oh, another Photoshop. Oh, Lawrence Max Payne. Oh, dude, you didn't. You did. Holy shit, hold on. Hold on a minute. Gosh. I really have to use the bathroom, but this is worth... This is worth capturing. Dude, thank you so much. Oh! Oh! You have no idea how happy you've made me. So I'm curious what picture you grabbed that from. making the perfect face and everything. God bless. God bless. I am hashtag blessed, so thank you. Thank you all. Ah, Steph's going to the start line. All right. I was thinking about going back to school for video production and editing, but I keep thinking my age 25 is holding me back, and I know I'm just being self-conscious about it and failing. Well, it's good that you know that. It's good that you know your reservations. I would say you don't have to pay somebody to learn how to edit. You can do that yourself, provided you have the kind of constitution that can read files, listen to videos, and just pick up your own stuff. So that's how I did it. So if you have the ability to read and learn on your own time, you don't have to pay somebody to learn how to edit or produce. You can do that yourself. So I'd recommend doing it. What it will require is patience and the understanding that you will be terrible for a long time. I'm saying like a year. So if you have the patience to do it all on your own for an entire year, look at your own stuff and squirm at how bad you are, but endure through that and continue learning and improving, then you can save a lot of money. But not a lot of people have the constitution to do that. So screen cap from an episode of The No. Ah, damn, Soccer Rocker. See, Soccer Rocker has a certain talent already. Wasn't a picture. Screen capped it from an episode of The No. I needed the right face, so I shopped around. You scrubbed through media to find the asset you needed, and then you pulled it into a photo. That's a very good talent, and you did it without being asked. And sorry, not to slob any knobs here, but that's exactly what is needed. That's exactly the skills that people like me or any other producer would be looking for. Not to say that you have a job waiting for you, Soccer Rocker, but that's the kind of thing. It's very, very good. So thank you for that. Morphe D, would I like to be a game dev? No, I've coded my own games in the past, and I can do it. But I enjoy talking about games more than I like making games. So I'll put it there. It's kind of like, if you are a lover of a medium, like if I can love movies, that doesn't mean I want to make movies. I just love ingesting them and talking about them and hopefully talking with the people who make them and maybe in a selfish way applauding them for what they do. That's kind of where I'm at. I think game design and game development is an impossible magic. And the people who are so good at it deserve to be celebrated. And that's kind of what I want to do. And by knowing coding and that aspect of it, I think it gives me a better appreciation of it. It's kind of like knowing about directing photography and about shooting on film and stuff like that. Knowing how to make a movie helps you appreciate movies. Helps you appreciate the technical aspects of it. And helps you appreciate the skill of the people who make them, as opposed to somebody just goes to a Michael Bay film and was like, the explosions were good. Well, yeah, but you can do that, or you can see a film, like you can see Hateful Eight shot on 8mm and be like, holy shit, these are practical shots shot on real film in natural lighting. This is some real fucking shit right here. And then that gives you a deeper appreciation of the talent involved in the production of it. So for me, I like consuming rather than producing. I think most Americans are that way. So I took the selfish route and decided to be a consumer instead of a producer. Although, I guess in the human centipede of American media, I'm also a producer. So people, the honest, hardworking people who actually make games are at the head. They don't have to eat shit, except they do, because they get driven into the ground. They make the games. I play the games and comment on them, and somehow I make a living doing that, which is the most unjust thing in the world, but it's there, so I do it, because that's awesome. There's no reason I should be paid for what I do, but I am, so I'm going to do it. And then there are people who consume that media somehow, and that's how the system works. It's all pretty fucked up. I feel like maybe in my lifetime, somehow the human experience will change where this period was rendered incomprehensibly stupid. The idea that there could be this middle layer that just plays and talks about games and somehow makes a living on that. I don't know. I feel like that should be universally the purview of hobbyist media and should never be paid for it. But, you know, if the money's there, a fool would turn it down. So somehow I weaseled my way in and got a paycheck out of it. So, you know what? That's my purview. Maybe a little too much rambling, but I think that's the end of the stream, because boy, it's Mother Nature howling at me. So thank you guys for watching. Oh man, Luke Garvey's in the stream. Nice to see you, man. Thanks for watching, everybody. I will not be your dad. Hey Leet, although you have a pretty great username. Any suggestions on what editing software you should start with to learn? The Adobe Suite is only $50 a month for Creative Cloud. So open up a new tab, punch in Adobe Creative Cloud, hit enter. If you have $50 a month to invest, which, to be honest, if you are sincere about making this transition in career, $50 a month is trivial, especially weighed against professional training. Get Adobe Creative Cloud, look up some tutorial videos, again, hit that Control T, type in Adobe Premiere Tutorial, hit Base One, get OBS, it's free, learn how to capture shit, again, if you don't know how, hit Control T and type that shit into Google and read and learn, and record your own capture, buy a webcam, Logitech webcams are $50, it's $20 with a .edu, motherfucker. God, you kids have it so good. Anyway, you have all the tools you need. If you have a part-time job, I promise you can scrimp out a little bit from your monthly budget and afford all of these professional tools, so you can use exactly what we use professionally, based on the rant I just went on, and you can learn how to do it. That's it. So, God bless. And yeah, I used GIMP for years, Luke Garvey. You're right on. GIMP is actually pretty good. And it was weird making the transition from GIMP to Photoshop. I had to basically learn the analogs for everything I already did. Yeah, the 920, Logitech 920, that's what I'm using right now. That's this thing. I wish I could turn this webcam around and show you. But So, there you go. Just make a way of it. Control T, type in what you want. And read and learn and make your own way. So, thank you guys for watching. That's it. I'm done ranting. I have to use the bathroom. So, thank you, everybody. Have a good night. Sleep well. Or have a good day if you're in the other half of the world. And I'll see you next time. See you guys.
The score. Legit. Better work hard. You might as well quit.
Platoon. Each level in Platoon is different, so you'll have to master...
Hey, Rocky, watch me pull a rabbit out of my hat.
Rocky, smoke, Polar Anchor.
It's the new Hershey's Kisses Snack Pack.
Wow, a message in a bottle.
Fan mail from some flounder.
No, it's our new snack pack again.
Look, there's 8 Hershey's Kisses inside.
Yum.
Each with that big taste of Hershey's chocolate.
And it's the same price as a candy bar. Again.
I gotta get me a new hat.
I gotta get the new Hershey's Kisses Snack Pack.
There is the hamburger side, and there is the tomato side. There is Pepe, and there is Mamsel. Ho, ho, ho. En garde, pigeon.
When those that are kept apart finally come together, it's not just good.
Meat is fantastic.
McDonald's new McDLT.
Excuse me.
Yes. How much is it going to cost?
I don't know. I'll have to ask.
Look, is my car ready yet?
I don't know. I'll have to ask.
Is this warranty good in Dubuque?
Every day, more and more Americans are becoming less satisfied with their car care. That's why Firestone developed MasterCare. With prices posted at the counter, MasterCare services that are warranted coast to coast and your car ready when promised. Because at Firestone, we're not satisfied until you're satisfied.
America's driving to Firestone.
Mondays. A network television premiere. The girl, the dream, the man she loved. The movie experience that electrified a generation. Flashdance.
Introducing new Chili Cheese Fritos brand. Spicy with chili, rich with cheese flavor, and a great corn taste and crunch of Fritos brand.
Hey, we know what we like, huh?
That's right. Now we just gotta hear it from the expert.
No expert! Yeah, chili man, come on! Yeah. All right, chili man! How does this work for you, huh?
Give us a word, huh?
Come on.
Come on?
Word!
New Chili Cheese Fritos. If you're a snacker, it's gotta be Fritos brand.
Tab's got a fabulous chance for you to win a free week at the famous spa and resort, La Costa. To enter, look for Tab's free guide, Spa Secrets from La Costa. It's filled with sassy secrets on fitness, fashion, and beauty. Plus, coupons for Tab and all these great products. You'll find Tab's free guide in these March magazines, along with your chance to go home a sassier you. So enter now to win.
Ooh, Tab's got it.
Next, it's hot action on Miami Vice when a high-octane killer cuts loose on the streets. And later, laugh it up with the king of comedy, Johnny Carson, when he welcomes Jimmy Stewart and Sheila E. to The Tonight Show starring Johnny Carson. Let's all be there.
Power team rules. How'd you like my boy Quirk? Not bad for a vegetable. Okay, it's time to get the video power edge. Our first tip is from Game Players Magazine for Ninja Gaiden 2 for NES. In stage 5-2, go for the one up behind the lower globe. But watch how Ryu glides from one edge to another. Wait until his enemy gets as far away as possible, then attack. Next up, Revenge of Shinobi for Genesis. Here's the way to get yourself an unlimited supply of shuriken. Select shuriken, now press A, B, and the C buttons as fast as you can. Faster, faster, keep punching the buttons until the infinity symbol appears. Under your number of shuriken. All the shuriken a player could want. The trick is fast fingers. Now, at the end of stage 5, you'll encounter a giant missile carrier. If you want to destroy it, you have to knock out all the flashing red spheres that keep popping up. But be careful. Be very careful. Don't get nailed by the sparks that are flying at you. Jump over them all and you'll be fine. But timing is very crucial. Okay, so it might not be easy, but if you do get it, you got it. The video power edge. The half hour is almost up, and I gotta get back to my games. But before I go, I want to tell you about the Video Power Bulletin Board. All you have to do is copy the address we're going to show you at the end of the show and then send stuff in. You know, video game questions, new game suggestions, tips, hints, photos, anything. So I'll see you tomorrow with more Power Team, Video Pinball, and Turtle Tips. That's Video Power. Video Power, P.O. Box 896, Madison Square Station, New York, New York. 10159. Game over.
Your day starts with fun when you tune into Fox 29 weekday mornings. At 6, it's Mighty Mouse, followed by the Thundercats. Then at 7, it's the hot new show that starts your day out right. Wake, Rattle, and Roll, followed by Merry Melodies, Alvin and the Chipmunks, and the new adventures of He-Man. Every weekday morning on Fox 29.
What waits this wizardry of wires when the warranty expires? You can bet she's one wonder you'll never forget. Small wonder.
Weekdays.
People to do Xbox 360, the holy grail of gaming, and it's all about customization, and there's nobody that knows more about that than these two guys from the Pimp My Ride team, my man Mike and my man Ryan. How you guys doing?
What's going on, Sway? How you doing?
Oh, man, I'm excited right now, man. How about you?
Absolutely, dog. When we found out they were coming out with the new Xbox, we definitely had to give it the West Coast touch.
Okay. We wanted to show Microsoft what we could do to the Xbox, dog, and all the next cars, they definitely gonna have that Xbox 360 in it. You know what I'm saying?
I know what you're saying, Mike. We're gonna take a look at exactly what it is that you guys did to pimp out the original Xbox.
Yo, this is Ryan from West Coast Custom. You know how we do it on Pimp My Ride? Usually, my man X is the one taking center stage. Today, a different X marks the spot. Gentlemen, today we have a very special assignment. In the past, we've used the box.
New Xboxes.
But now it's time to pimp the box. So Mad Mike, what do you got?
Let's make it sinister, but industrial style. The first thing we had to do is take the Xbox all apart. We had the guy sand it down and get it ready for Buck to paint. Then Buck airbrushed skull and crossbones right on the top. Then after that, Sean took and cut metal pieces, welded it, and mounted a monitor, put the LEDs in the skull, and made it work.
All right, Mad Mike, show me what you got, dog.
Check this out, Shady. We got a 15-inch flip-up monitor. We got the LEDs, we got the skull and the crossbones, and check out that bling. This is the way the Xbox should look. You've been pimped.
What you guys got?
A little less metal, bling, yes, and then maybe a ring as well.
Yeah, a ring, that's a good idea. I think we can do something.